Okay, coming into my dungeon. I just got back from running some errands, and I had to see my doctor also. So I'm gonna show you guys how I prepped all this for my pouring today. Liquitas acrylic medium is a very good pouring medium for these. I'm using these paints again. See, and this time I have a very big black canvas. I paint the black last night just to leave it overnight like that. So what I did was I put 2 spoons of this type of pouring medium in each of these little cups. 2 spoons, that's it. And then the pouring medium, I put also about 2 spoons, maybe three spoons. All right. And then on the black background, these have pouring medium in them. But this is for the background because, you know, in order to have paint spread through a dry canvas like this, you have to wet the background in order to get anything moving. Otherwise, you will not have anything moving at all. Okay, so learn that. And this water is so that I could thin out these paints if I feel they're not thin enough. I think they're pretty good. The consistency looks good. But I may add a little bit more water just to spread it out more. It depends. So I'm going to put you guys up and I'm going to start showing you how I do my art. All right, let me.
Hi, all. It's me, Ange. I'm going to do a pour now. And it's going to be with the paint I did the other day, the same paints. I'll show you more or less what it's going to, more or less I showed already earlier on how you I mixed it, okay, and how it worked for me. So I'm going to, put my hair up and start doing these pours so that you can see how I do them, okay? Let me push this back. My phone instead of showing you guys anything. Well, you won't be seeing the thing. My ring light is unbelievable. I gotta get a new one for sure. Yeah. After a while they get tired of you. Let me see. Yeah, you can see back here. But I'm gonna go behind the And I'm going to put on my smock because I have my regular clothes on and my husband would get so upset if I paint any more clothes. I promise him I won't anymore. My poor Mikey's always buying me new clothes and I'm always getting them full of paint. Yeah. So I'm just going to put on my smock and what I'm going to do is bring you forward. See, well, you can't see from back there, that's too far out. So, what I'm gonna do is I have to bring you forward all the way over here. Let's see if over here you can see. Push things around. And very handy, you know, these Acrylics. Acrylic little flat thingies, rubber thingies. My husband laughed because I call them thingies. He says you call everything thingies. I gotta have more coffee again. Sorry. I just feel like this is not right. Let me turn the light. So you don't want too watery, but you don't want it too thick either. Because thick will not move anywhere. Thick will stay just where you throw it. Put that one there. Try not to throw too much in the background so I'll have more to move my paint around. So this is the paint that's been going around, 10 Tammy Anderson. You could go to her tutorials. Erica Thornton is using it too. You could go to her tutorial. You can also go to Priscilla. Oh my God, I forgot her last name. She's gonna kill me. She's from Florida, Priscilla. She pours like 2 or 3 times a day. She is a busy lady. And she does some really good exhibits also. So you may want to go see her as well. And the name of the paints are the Prizm Pour Metallic, Ultra Metallic, Multi-Surface Acrylic Paint. For canvas, wood, metal, and even glass. You could mix it with pouring medium. You could mix it with GAC 800. You could, it's supposed to be, you know, to thin it out. You could dilute it with 20% or less of varnish or liquid pouring medium. And what else? Do not use high quality of quantities of Floetrol, American Floetrol. Because it might make it matte the color and reduce the intensity of the metallic finish. Surface, canvas, wood, metal, glass, best results when finished with the varnish or epoxy top coat. Soap and water for cleanup. It comes off so easily. It comes off just like paint. And I painted with this, my lady. You know, the lady I did the other day with the Chidol Gold. My Golden Temple lady. I painted her with this one. Mm-hmm. So I use it for acrylic painting. So I guess you could use it for whichever, you know, art piece you want to do. Let's go around here and get this all off. And put it right in that corner. Now swipe it up. So kind of mix it all up so that it could reach the corners of your canvas. You don't have to go over because then you're, I mean, if you have a table like mine, it's small, so I can't go over too much because all the paint will end up on the floor, which is what I don't want. So I'm just going kind of to the edges. And I hope you all can hear me. Thank you to all my new subscribers, all my likes. All my continued people that view my art, please hit like. Like is the most important button on these, you know, YouTube videos. Hit. Okay, so here we go. Put that orange in there. It looks like an orange. I gotta look at the colors, and I will write it down in the description when you guys come and look at the description. So you know what colors I'm using. Yeah. Oh, the screen is so pretty too. I'm gonna put this right in this corner here. Alright, so let's throw the screen. Keep the paint up. You don't want the paint to disappear on you. So yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna put the next color here. And that's this green. That's a different green, and that one is more like a turquoise. This one more like a bluish turquoise color. What do you think, guys? Yeah, maybe I'm pouring too many colors in one plank here. Yeah, let's make a party of it.
Yeah.
Okay. A little bit of white. I'll put a little bit of white in there. Mm-hmm.
this pink over here. And now my favorite color in the world. Purple. We love purple. I do love purple. My dad used to call me a little girl because he always said, "You always act like a little girl. You don't even like your age." I'll put these foams in water because they wash right off, like just like acrylic paints, they wash right off. So here we go, guys. Let's get the spatula and get it going here. Yeah. Look how beautiful is those colors. Yeah. And you kind of, you know, just swipe them and try not to swipe too much on top of each other more than once. You want to kind of try to keep your swiping down to maybe one time, because you don't want it to cover the black to come on top and just cover your whole painting. So that's what you do. And I'm now wiping my palette. Now I'm gonna go into another color. So since I don't want the colors mixed too much, I'm gonna my spatula, because it's a big canvas, I use a spatula. If it's a small canvas, then I use a small, you know, little tiny, one of my tiny, some purple in the corner, why not, right? You can mix the colors, it's your painting. Do whatever you want, it's your, you're the painter here. You're the one that's gonna sell your art here. No one else. Let's wash this again. I don't have a big bucket of water. I should get a bucket of water when I do these, because then I can just, you know, clean it through. Down too hard, because you can make your colors disappear. Because remember, this is black. Black is something that could ruin your paint instead of making them better. So you gotta be careful with black, with the color black. Yeah, like this. So beautiful. I love the green. The green. It's gorgeous. This green. Oh my god. So gorgeous. Gorgeous. And I love the way it dries. It dries so beautiful. The last one I did, it dried so tremendously beautiful. I put the garbage can all the way over there, now I've got to keep walking all the way to it. Set up my own trap here. Look at this blue. I love this blue. Oh my god. I think that's the one I put a little bit of silicone in one of them. I think it was that blue I put a little silicone in. So if you guys haven't been reading my, a lot of my stories, I write a lot of stories about my art right below in the description, so you can read more about my life and the stories that I put up, you know, about family, the things that we're going through right now with the COVID and all that. You know, I like to keep my stories going. It gives me a way to kind of vent out and not talk to people, because sometimes people can't take the negativity, and I don't blame them. It's too much negativity. Nobody wants to hear negativity all the time. All right. This is looking gorgeous.
You also, if you want to get one of these spatulas, you could get it from Heather Mater's account on Amazon. She has it there. You can go and get it. She's really good at these swiping techniques also. So you may want to give a little, you know, a little props on it and these things. She's really a very good artist who deserves a lot more praise. Swipe it too deep into it. Not get too deep into it, just a little tiny nudge on the white. Yeah. I'm gonna leave that white there like that so I can show some kind of white there. You know, because I want some of the white to show. So, yeah. Leave it like that. This orange here in this corner, it's a very nice, beautiful orange. Yeah. Just a little bit like that, it's okay. No music, I don't want the, get another strike. I keep getting strikes after strikes after strikes. I forget to turn off the music. Yeah, you get old, you watch. Your brain is not going to work the same. Everything starts colliding together, and you're like, oh my lord, what the heck did I just say or do? Finish. I love the way it's looking. I like the way everything is appearing here, especially like right here around this orange, and it looks like copper all around it. But that's all the orange and the black. It looks really amazing how pretty it looks. Yeah, you gotta go over it and make sure you don't have no little holes anywhere. Absorb your painting. Do that. This corner to have it to cover that whole area. This green. Okay, well, this is like a greenish blue mostly. It's such a pretty color, also. And as you notice, I'm going a little deeper here because I want some of the black to show. I don't exactly want to get rid of all the black, I want the black to show very nicely, yeah.
this that I said to you guys, you could use this to spread some paint. You could just lay it down softly. Don't push down on it too much. Very soft. Let's see. Just a gentle tap on it. You don't need to push down hard on it. And you'll give it a nice cool color there. That purple. Get that purple to show to the red and the black as well. So. It's all done. Look at it good and make sure it looks, you know, cohesive. You don't want anything to look not so good. You want everything to be as you want it to be. Just make sure everything is covered nicely. Yeah. Because it is a big canvas, I don't want it to not look good. I don't want it to look very beautiful. This should be. So, and the good thing about these kind of paints is you keep swiping it and it just keeps shimmering more and more. It just keeps showing up more and more bright. So, no matter how many times you swipe it, you get a nice shimmer coming through. So, that's the good thing about these paints. I could just swipe it and a nice shimmer would come right out of nowhere. So, I say this is another paint. I'm going to give you guys a close-up now. Let me put this fire. away. Make sure your fire torch, you do not leave it anywhere. You could cause a fire. Always work with precaution in mind, because it doesn't matter whether you're a pour painter, a regular painter, a resin art painter. Just make sure that everything you have, you put away very nice, and just make sure that everything is put away very nice and, you know, in the proper area, and that it's not going to cause any fire in your house or your basement. I'm in a basement, so. And I should have put my hair up, you know why? Because my hair ends up on some of my pins sometimes. So, I hope it's not at this point. But I remember once I did a resin pour. Such a beautiful resin pour. And once it dried, 24 hours after, a strand of my hair in that white paint. I almost lost it because, you know, resin is expensive. So anyway, that's another thing to remember. But this painting is done. I'm going to give you a close-up, all right? Thank you very much. Left-hand corner. There you go. My painting. I got to go over that. You see that area looks a little dented there. I'm going to go over that. So I'm just going to swipe it a few more times there. You could always add a little black to it once it's all dry anyways. So it doesn't matter. And look at this. I love the way this one took place. The orange. It's like it became a different color altogether. Do you see all the shimmery that goes on in this paint? Such beautiful shimmer everywhere. Mm-hmm. Look at the pink. To die for. Look at the blue and the green again. Yeah, little tiny little cells there. I didn't put any type of cell producing stuff in this paint. I did swiping, but just a little swiping. I didn't do a whole bunch of swiping. There go a little bit of cells. I'm not one that cares a lot about cells. Cells do not make you an artist. If you get stuck in that, you'll be stuck in that forever and you'll never move on with your art. So, yeah. Look at this one here in this corner. I love how this one came out in this corner. Look at that. Isn't that cute? Love it. Yeah, and look at this green. How magical is this green? It's like a turquoise green. Look at it. It's so beautiful. I could think of so many reasons to use these for a regular paint. Like make a sky like that. And it looks like a nice, beautiful cloud. Sky. Uh-huh. And a bunch of little cells in here too. And that one I put a little bit of the... what do you call it? And that purple, yeah, I have put a little bit of the that conditioner, the Minwax, is it? Yeah, I put just one, like four drops in it, pre-stain with conditioner. I just put that in the purple, but very little. So that's why I got very little cells there. That's it, guys. You see, it's a pretty nice big canvas. It's a gallery wrap canvas. And don't forget, you can get these paints at Amazon or go to Sakya Smith. She is on YouTube, she's on Instagram, and she's on Facebook. And now for the holidays, she's got some pretty good sales, okay? And even now that it's over the, you know, the holidays, this is very good paint. Okay, love you all. God bless. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye.